In this video lecture, we're going to take a closer look at the details of Java's three types of conditional operators and provide usage examples of each one. Okay, let's get started. Here we see the first of Java's conditional operators. It's two equality operators, equal and not equal. Both of these are binary operators, and we use them to compare the values of their left-hand side and right-hand side expressions for equality or inequality. Its two operands are typically two variables or expressions which evaluate to some primitive numerical type, and the result is one single Boolean value, either true or false. One common mistake or gotcha when using these operators is to use a single equal instead of a double equal to test for equality. Remember that a single equal sign operator indicates data assignment, whereas the double equal sign is performing comparison or asking a simple question. Are these two values equal to each other? Yes or no? To perform value comparison, you need this double equal operator. Misuse of this can be a very subtle bug to find in a program, because using an assignment operator when you want comparison will usually compile just fine, but evaluate to a hardwired logical true, which can be difficult to spot in your code. One other common gotcha is trying to use an equality operator to compare two objects field by field, which is instead a job for that object's equals method. Again, this will usually compile and execute and return a result, but it may be a true result for the wrong reasons, as we'll see in the next example. So remember to always use the equals method to compare two objects field by field. Here's a simple code example demonstrating the use of the equality and inequality operators. Here we are declaring a numerical value for age and another numerical constant for a threshold value. We are also setting up three strings and trying to perform comparisons between them, both incorrectly and correctly. Just below, we are setting the five declared Boolean conditions equal to these various conditional expressions, then printing them out as we would any other regular variables. The results of these print statements are shown here at the right. Once again, I want to stress that this kind of usage of conditional expressions in isolation is not typical of how we'll usually see them used in our programs. Here, I'm just trying to emphasize the point that such expressions themselves roll up into one single Boolean value, but usually such expressions are embedded within the selection logic we'll be writing. To see the results of this code for some other input data, please take a moment now to pause this video and view the short code walkthrough for operatorsequality.java, which you'll find in the usual place. Open up this file in JGrasp so you can follow along, then come back to this video when you are finished. Next, here is a table showing the next set of Java's conditional operators. It's four relational operators. Just like for the equality operators, these are also binary operators, and they are used to compare the relative values of their left-hand side and right-hand side operands. These operands are typically two variables or expressions, which each evaluate to one single numeric value of one of the primitive data types. And once again, that entire conditional expression will evaluate to one single Boolean result, either true or false. These four relational operators should look familiar from a prior prerequisite CS course, or from previous math classes. In order, they are less than or equal to, greater than, and greater than or equal to. Let's take a look at some examples of using these. This example, which shows the use of relational operators, is very similar to the prior one. Once again, we are defining a numerical age in a threshold value, then comparing the two against each other using all four relational operators, as we see here. Each of these comparisons is expressed as a conditional expression. The result is assigned to a Boolean variable and then printed out with a label in the usual fashion, with the results shown here on the right. The only wrinkle to point out in this example is that the conditional result depends on whether or not the endpoint is included in the comparison. For example, in this first case, we are checking to see if the age 21 is less than the threshold age 21. Yes or no? Well, of course, 21 is not less than 21, so the result C1 is of course false, as we see here. But then in the next case, we are including the endpoint in the comparison. Is the age 21 less than or equal to the threshold age 21? Of course, this time the answer is true, as we see here on the right. To see the results of this code for some other input data, Please take a moment now to pause this video and view the short code walkthrough for operatorsrelational.java, which you'll find in the usual place. Open up this file in JGrasp so you can follow along, then come back to this video when you are finished. Finally, here are the last three conditional operators in Java, the three logical operators. These operators are used to construct more complex, compound logical expressions by gluing together simpler expressions formed with equality and/or relational operators. We have the three basic Boolean operators, not, and or, which are at the heart of all computing logic. Note that the not operator is a unary operator, which means that it is applied to only one single operand, whereas the other two are binary operators, and each take two operands, one on the left and one on the right. The key difference with these three operators is that their operands must now be Boolean values or expressions, not numerical ones. So again, we use these operators to join together simpler equality or relational expressions, which themselves yield true-false Boolean results. By way of review, here is the truth table for all three logical operators, along with their symbolic logic gate representations. A truth table simply summarizes the logical output values for all possible combinations of logical inputs. As you may recall, for n independent input values, there will always be 2 to the n possible combinations of those inputs. So for these two inputs, A and B, these are the four possible input combinations. All of the inputs are now Boolean values, either true or false. The NOT operator, or the NOT logic gate, simply inverts or flips its input value. So if the one single input A is true, the output will be false. And if the input A is false, the output will be true. Pretty simple. The AND is a binary operator, which means it takes two operands, or two inputs, to its logic gate. The result of the AND operator is true only for the case where both of its inputs are logical true, and false for all other input combinations. The OR is also a binary operator, but by contrast, the result of the OR operator is true if either or both of its inputs are logical true, and false only if both of its inputs are logical false. Hopefully all of this looks familiar from a prior CS prerequisite course, but it's just presented here as a refresher. This is how logic is implemented in hardware, specifically in microprocessors. But this is how the equivalent logic is implemented in software. As it turns out, it's not always necessary to fully evaluate a logical expression to arrive at a result. Logical operators evaluate their operands going from left to right. If it's possible to determine the outcome of the overall logical expression by evaluating the first operand only, the second operand does not need to be evaluated, a case known as short-circuit evaluation. Specifically, if the first operand of some OR expression evaluates to true, it doesn't matter what the second operand is, the overall result will always be a logical true. Similarly, if the first operand of some AND expression evaluates to false, once again, it doesn't matter what the second operand is, the overall result will always be a logical false. This might not seem like such a big deal, but in a sizable program having lots of logic to evaluate, it can lead to some execution speed efficiencies. Here's an example which demonstrates the usage of the logical operators to create compound conditional expressions. What we're doing here is setting up several age thresholds we want to compare against, and this time we're setting up an input scanner object so that we can read in an age down here to perform comparisons upon. Down here, we are again assigning the results of these conditional expressions to some declared Boolean conditional variables. But notice that now we are performing some compound tests using logical operators. Here, we have a logical or AND operator in the middle of an expression, but the operands on the left or right side are themselves simpler relational expressions, which each evaluate to one single Boolean result. Here, 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 and here. So these interior logical operators are gluing together two Boolean results into one larger overall Boolean result. In this first example, we're checking to see if the age puts a person in either the child or the senior categories. If your age is 12 or less, or your age is 65 or greater, then this entire expression evaluates to true, and it is true that you are a child or a senior. In this second example, We are instead checking to see if the age puts a person into the grown-up category, old enough to be an adult, but not old enough yet to be a senior. If your age is 18 or greater, and your age is less than 65, then this entire expression evaluates to true, and you are indeed a non-senior adult. Also, note the short circuit evaluation that may be taking place. If the first condition of this first OR expression is true, there's no need to evaluate the rest of the expression. Similarly, if the first condition of this second AND expression is false, there's no need to evaluate the rest of the expression. Again, we're just using logical operators to combine simpler conditional expressions into larger ones. Using parentheses liberally to group the logical cases, as we're doing here, is a good way to make the program logic clearer to yourself. Up here on the right, we can see the program outputs for several different ages. To see this code execute for some other age cases, please take a moment now to pause this video and view the short code walkthrough for operatorslogical.java, which you'll find in the usual place. Open up this file in JGraph so you can follow along, then come back to this video when you are finished.